I'll be honest with you, this is not the video that I wanted to make. I was working on a very cool project, but I had to put it in the back burner because I had to make this video. I had to make this video because I'm seeing so much controversy online about whether or not we need social distancing, so much uncertainty about our future, and so much confusion about how long this is going to last. There's just too much information going around. Some is right and some is wrong. Some is based on actual data and some is pure speculation. Different statistical models arrive to different conclusions, and even experts disagree on some key issues. Some people are saying that this is just like the flu and it isn't a big deal. Other people are saying that this is basically the end of the world as we know it. I think the truth is somewhere in the middle. I'll share with you my analysis of the situation, but I'm not gonna tell you what to do. I'm here to give you information so you can make the best decision for you and your family. What makes coronavirus so dangerous is how easily it spreads. The metric we use to measure how contagious viruses are is known as R0. The R0 value of coronavirus is around 2. That means that every person who gets it is likely to pass it to 2 other people. In Italy and New York, cases have been doubling every 2 or 3 days. At this rate, 100 cases today can become 100,000 cases in a month. We can't eliminate coronavirus. It's here to stay, just like measles or chickenpox. But unlike these other viruses, we don't have a vaccine for coronavirus yet. Until we do, our goal is to slow down its spread so our healthcare system has enough resources to take care of people that actually require hospitalization. This dotted line represents the resources we have available to treat infected people. This is stuff like hospital beds, doctors, nurses, respirators. Without protective measures, the spread will happen fast and many people will die due to a lack of proper care. That's what's happening in Italy at the moment. Doctors are having to decide who gets a respirator and who doesn't, who gets to live and who gets to die. But with protective measures, coronavirus will spread much more slowly, allowing everyone to get the care they need. Coronavirus will continue killing people, but it's up to us how many. With protective measures, the total number of deaths expected in the US is 200,000. Without them, that number is 1.7 million. That means that in the US alone, learning how to protect ourselves can save 1.5 million lives. You probably heard the term social distancing 1,000 times by now. So let's see what we can learn from countries that implemented it and countries that didn't. Take a look at the number of daily new cases in China. It was growing fast, but when they implemented a total lockdown, it plummeted. Compare that with countries like Italy, Iran, Spain that didn't implement social distancing right away. Now, let me say this, I get it. Social distancing sucks. We want to see our friends, we want to hang out with our family, we want to go to work, we want to keep the economy strong. But coronavirus is here and we can't pretend it isn't. We need to be smart about our choices. We have 2 options. We can deal with a big problem now or with a bigger problem later. Every day we delay social distancing, we increase the number of cases by 40%. So the sooner we start, the sooner we can contain the spread, get it under control, and return to our normal lives. I want to answer 2 of the most important questions that I see people asking. The first one is, how long can we expect social distancing to last? The second one is, how strict does it need to be? Are we supposed to be home for months? We need protective measures until we reach what's known as herd immunity. Herd immunity means that we as a society are well protected against the virus. That's when we manage to get the R0 factor to 1 or less. And we do that by making sure that half of the population is immunized. So the base R0 factor of 2 becomes 1 when 50% of the population is immune to the virus. One way to become immune to the virus is to get it. Most experts agree that after getting the virus once, we're unlikely to get it again, at least for a few years. The other way is through a vaccine. Experts predict that in about 12 months, we'll have a vaccine to immunize older people and people with weaker immune systems. If we limit the amount of social interaction we have during this period, we'll minimize the number of people who require hospitalization, and this way avoid exceeding the capacity of our healthcare system. A healthcare system working properly or being overwhelmed is the difference between a 5% death rate and a 0.5% death rate. Until we reach herd immunity, we need to avoid 1, getting the virus, and 2, passing it to others. The best way to do that is to stay home. If we can stay home, we should. At least for a couple of weeks to keep this problem as small as possible. As we slow down the spread, I expect lockdowns to gradually loosen up. When that happens, we will see the virus resurge in some areas. My prediction is that we'll transition from worldwide lockdowns to regional governments reinstating social distancing only in areas with new outbreaks. We don't need to live in fear. we need to be smart and make informed decisions. If you're able to leave the house and go for a walk without getting close to other people or touching surfaces that might be infected, I think it's a good idea to clear your mind and get some exercise. I'm lucky enough to live in Oregon and be surrounded by nature, so I've been hiking daily and that's been amazing for my mental health. As far as seeing other people, we are social animals and we can't be locked down for a whole year. Eventually, we'll want to start seeing people again, so we'll need to make sure we do that safely. I've been seeing people at parks hanging out a few feet apart, and although I'm personally choosing to wait a couple of weeks before doing something like that, I think it's great how, as a society, we're finding creative and safe ways to take our lives back. My prediction is that it's gonna be a while before we can attend concerts or sports events, but probably only a couple of weeks before we can go back to work and see our friends and family. So we need to accept the fact that life will be a bit different in the near future. But I'm confident that we'll adapt to it and get through it together. Don't let fear take over your life. You don't need fear. You don't need stress. You need to stay safe and make informed decisions. In the next video, I'll show you how you can boost your immune system to protect yourself against the coronavirus and a number of other common viruses. So subscribe to MindHacks YouTube channel and follow me on Instagram at MindHacksTV. Please like this video and make sure you share it with your friends and family to educate them about the coronavirus. My name is Zeke Musio and this is MindHacks TV. See you next week with a new mind hack.